Probably the reason I hate him so much is because I'm a dad, and I've got this fear that one day my daughters will bring something like that home. And he'll come in and go, oh, such pleasure to be in your charming abode. Mother-in-law is very delicious.
Hey guys, so this is the late comedian Sean Locke on 8 out of 10 Cats. This episode was from 2014, and as you can see here, he is making a bit of a jibe about Russell Brand, how he fears that one day his daughters will bring home someone like him. Not really sure we can see this as an indication that he's pointing towards Russell Brand's reputation as a Lothario, but certainly Sean Locke was not a fan of his. In fact, he has more pointed things to say about Russell Brand's political opinions in the same episode of this show.
There's one person who didn't wear a mask, isn't there? Russell Brand. And I think the funny thing is that he's the only one not wearing a mask, because obviously if he wore a mask, people wouldn't know he was there, would they? I mean, so it's a big publicity for his book.
What's it called?
Revolution. In fact, if his book's called Revolution, he shouldn't be out there trying to sell it. He should be trying to encourage people to steal it. Shouldn't he? Yeah. You know, all it's ended up, he's backpedalled so much now. He started out saying, don't vote, it's stupid, pointless to vote, don't vote. But he's now come out, Russell Brand, and said, no, what I'm saying is, actually, he goes, who am I supposed to vote for? So if you reduce that to what he's actually saying, it's what everybody says at every bus stop or news agency, you go, politicians, what are they like, eh? How that lot get in? Oh, no, bloody hell.
And his points are valid, because at that time there were protests around Parliament. I believe there was a huge protest going on where people had decided to camp out in Parliament Square, and there were all these questions raised. And this was kind of around the time Russell Brand decided to become all political. And I remember back then thinking, I don't quite understand what he's talking about, because there was a whole lot of confusion behind his rhetoric.
The main problem is now is people get the politicians they deserve because they don't take any interest in politics. Mm-hmm. And him saying stuff to people who are disaffected already and aren't engaged with the political process, don't vote, is the most moronic, self-serving, pathetic bit of attention-seeking wank that has ever
It's also been announced today that Russell Brand's YouTube channel has been demonetized. Oh, wow, I bet he's quaking in his boots about that. I mean, I doubt he really makes that much money from it, to be honest. People have said he made $1 million a year from it, but he's a very wealthy man, and I'm assuming a lot of that went towards running costs anyway. I don't really see what YouTube can do in this situation. The only thing I think they could possibly do to really harm him would be to completely deplatform him and take him off YouTube altogether, and then he'd just be limited to Rumble. But again, I'm not sure whether they can legally do that when someone's been accused of stuff. Until they are actually found guilty, then I just think that his channel has to stay there. And even the demonetization, I don't quite understand, because I don't know what policy they're basing that on. Because there are loads of YouTubers who are far less famous than Russell Brand, who have done terribly shocking things. But I think a lot of them are still on YouTube, and they're still monetized. So, not quite sure how that policy works. But nonetheless, so there you go. Sean Locke talking about Russell Brand many years ago, and maybe saying a few things that a lot of people now certainly feel perhaps even more strongly than prior to the accusations made against him. And of course, you watch those videos and you think, wow, I really miss Sean Locke. He was a great part of the alternative comedy establishment in this country, and it's a shame I still can't believe he's gone, to be honest with you. But there we go. Well done, Sean Locke.
Russell Brand joined thousands of angry people protesting against capitalism. It was a great night for Russell. He managed to shift 5,000 copies of his new book.